Picture this, it's 2025, and your favorite Windows game, running on Linux through Proton, hits higher FPS and smoother frame times than native Windows. Mind blown yet? Today, we're diving deep. Why Linux beats Windows in gaming, even emulated. What's choking Windows, and game-changing fixes to make Windows nearly as fast. These tweaks could boost your FPS by 60%. Let's roll. First, we need to kill a myth. When you play Cyberpunk 2077 or Elden Ring on a Steam Deck or a Linux desktop, you aren't emulating the hardware. You aren't simulating a virtual CPU. You are using Proton. Proton is a translation layer. Think of it like this. Windows speaks a language called DirectX. Linux speaks a language called Vulkan. Proton is simply a translator standing in the middle. Here is where the magic happens. DirectX 11, which thousands of games still use, is old. It's heavy on the CPU and struggles to use multiple cores effectively. When Proton translates DirectX 11 into Vulkan, it isn't just copying the commands, it's effectively upgrading the API. Vulkan is a modern, low-level beast. It talks directly to the GPU with almost zero overhead. Because Vulkan is so much more efficient than legacy DirectX, the time it takes to translate the code is actually shorter than the time it takes Windows to process the native DirectX code. The result? You aren't just running the game on Linux, you are running the game on a superior graphics pipeline. But graphics APIs are only half the story. The real killer is the operating system itself. Imagine two runners. Runner A is Linux. He is wearing running shorts and expensive shoes. That's it. Runner B is Windows. He is wearing a tuxedo, carrying a briefcase, and has a backpack full of rocks. Windows is a general-purpose operating system, designed for everyone. It has to run printers, legacy apps from 1998, corporate security tools, and telemetry services that track your usage. Even when you are gaming, Windows is busy in the background. It's indexing files for search, it's running Windows Defender scans, it's updating widgets, it's compositing the desktop with the Desktop Window Manager, or DWM. This creates OS overhead. Every time your CPU has to pause the game to handle a background Windows task, you get a micro stutter. Linux doesn't do this. The Linux kernel scheduler is incredibly efficient. It knows that the game is the priority. It isolates the game process and gives it all the resources. This is why, even if the average FPS is the same on both OSs, Linux almost always feels smoother. The 1% lows, those little dips that ruin immersion, are much higher on Linux. So, do you have to uninstall Windows and learn Linux to get smooth gaming? Not necessarily. While you can't change the core architecture of Windows, you can strip it down. We can take those rocks out of the backpack. Step 1. Fix the memory management. Windows has a notorious bug with the standby list. It fills up your RAM with cache data and forgets to clear it, causing massive stutters in games like Battlefield or Hogwarts Legacy. A free tool called ISLC monitors this and forces Windows to clear the cache. This single tool can eliminate micro stutters for thousands of users. Step 2. Debloat. You need to turn off the noise. Tools like O&O Shutup 10++ or Bloaty Nosy allow you to disable telemetry, data collection, and unnecessary background services with a single click. By silencing these background tasks, you give your CPU more breathing room to focus on rendering frames. Step 3. Fix the scheduler. Since the Windows scheduler is lazy, do it yourself. Using software like Process Lasso, you can force your PC to prioritize the game process above everything else. You can also disable core parking, which stops your CPU from going to sleep mid-game. If those tweaks aren't enough, there is the nuclear option, custom ISOs. Projects like Atlas OS take the Windows installer and surgically remove the bloat before you even install it. They strip out Windows Defender. They remove the Microsoft Store. They delete the printer spoolers and the tracking services. The difference is night and day. A stock Windows install might have 150 processes running idle. A custom ISO can get that down to 40. On older PCs or budget hardware, this is life-changing. It reduces input lag and frees up RAM. However, be warned, these are modified versions of Windows. They sacrifice security and compatibility for raw speed. If you use your PC for banking or work, stick to the safe tweaks. But if you want a pure gaming machine that rivals Linux, this is the way. So, here is the verdict. Linux performs better because it is built better. It is lighter, smarter, and uses Vulkan to bypass the bottlenecks of the past. Windows is held back by 20 years of legacy code and corporate bloat. But with the right tools, you can fight back. You can debloat, optimize, and tune Windows to get within striking distance of that Linux performance. Whether you switch to the Penguin or strip down Windows, the goal is the same. Your hardware deserves to run at its limit. Don't let your operating system stand in the way. If you want a step-by-step guide to optimizing Windows safely, let me know in the comments. Drop a comment, Linux or tuned Windows? Want my exact debloat guide? Like, subscribe, hit the bell, more gaming tips coming. Thanks for watching.